Hello everyone. Today I want to teach you how to create running headers that include numbering. In the tutorial before, we learned how to create headlines with numbering, and we also learned how to create running headers. I'm going to recap on those tutorials a little bit, but I also will include annotations where you can click and watch the exact tutorial how we created the headlines and the running headers. We have, again, for this tutorial, as always, sample documents that you can download from our website, and I put the link in the YouTube description. So let's get started with our running headers. We have here our headlines and the running header. In this tutorial today, we want to learn how to get the numbering from our headlines in front of our running header. But let's first recap on the things we see on this page. If we take a look at our headlines, those are paragraph styles, where I have included automatic numbering. You see those things here. Also in this paragraph styles, we have nested styles that we need for a running header. So this is a character style that gets applied to the headline and can therefore be detected by the running header. Let's take a look at our running header. We find those in text variables. Define and then on running header edit, and we see here we're taking the character styles that is applied to the first and second level headline. You also see by this dotted line here that this is actually on a master page, so in the master A that is applied to all those pages, we just include the text variable running header, and this creates the running header on all our pages. So you see here, it is grabbing second level headline and writing it down here as well on the next pages. So now let's talk about how to get the numbering here on the headlines. Sadly, there is no function in InDesign CS5 to do this automatically, but I'm going to show you now a workaround that makes this more or less practical. We're going to start by creating a new character style. And we call this one running header numbers. Then we're also going to change the color and we click on OK. Next, we want to go into our headline, and at the end of this headline, we're going to insert a new cross reference. We click on this button here, and as this is a first level headline, we have to choose head 1. And here, we're going to include only the paragraph number. So this 3, and we go on edit and activate character style for cross reference. In here we select running header numbers. Also at the beginning of this cross reference we want to insert an end for our nested style. So we go on end nested style, this inserts this one here, and we want to insert a point at the end because our number is only a 3 and we want to have a 3 point. We're going to save this one under new name, and then we can click on OK. And now we see here, we have our 3 with a point. We can click on OK again. And we also have to do the same thing for the other headlines. So we're just going to do this as an example for a level 2 headline. We go on new cross reference, and then here we select head 2 because this is a level 2 headline. If we would do the same thing for level 3 headline here, we would select head 3. However, for head 2 and head 3, we need to edit our cross reference style because we need to remove this point that we use for the level 1 headline. So we're going to duplicate this style here and we delete this point, and also we change the name. We want to have this again be based on running header numbers. And we can click on OK. Now you see it has the same style as the top one, but the point here is missing. We can click on OK, and you would do this for all your headlines in your text. However, at the moment, our third level headline is not included in our running header system, so we would only need to do it for level 1 and level 2 headlines. I'm going to do this really quick for the other headlines. And you need, of course, to watch out to select also the right headline in here. So this should have the same numbers. They should match. Now it's time to include our numbers right here into our running header. To do this, we need to go on type, and then here we need to define a new text variable. We can create a new one, and we call this one running header numbers, and we want to have it based on a character style, and this character style is the running header numbers character style, and we use the first one on the page. We can go on OK and on Done. And if we go now on our master page, master A, we're going to insert this one right here. Let's insert a tab also. And then here we insert variable and running header numbers. Let's take a look what happens now. You see the 3 was included in here. And also on the next page, you see the 3.2 from down here was included. However, the spacing between the number and our headline is a little bit off. This is a little bit bigger than it is here. So this should be 10 millimeters. So we need to repair this. Therefore, we go to master A again. And in here, let's also assign a new paragraph style for this. And we call this one running header. In here, in the tabs menu, we need to insert this tab here. Just click in here. And we set this one to 10 millimeters. Let's click on OK. And let's take a look if it's now repaired. Yeah, this looks OK. And now we only need to get rid of this 3.1 here. So we can't really remove it, but we can change the color to white or to the paper color we use. And also we can increase the size to 0.1 pt. And by the way, the slash you see here is the symbol, the blue one, that the nested style ends here. Because if we wouldn't have this, it would include this 3.1 also in here. So this is just an info for you so you know where the slash comes from. Let's reduce the size of this one here. We go to our character styles and running header numbers. We edit this one and on character color, we select paper. And on formatting, we choose a very, very small size. So 0.1 pt should be fine. And we see now here, if we check on preview, it almost disappears. We can click on OK. And there we have our numbered running headers. One thing to keep in mind is if you insert a few headlines, for example here, a level 2 headline, it might change the numbering. So you would need to update your cross references from time to time. Also, another thing you see here, the last word is underlined. To solve this problem, we're going to go on our hyperlinks again, and we're going to edit the style. We're just going to insert a space in the beginning of each style. We're going on save, and we also going to do this in the second style here. Save again, and then we can click on OK, and on OK, and now you see the problem is gone. If you still work on your document, it might be a good idea to change this character style here for the number that we can't see right now, so that you can see it, so you know when something is messed up or not. So let's change this back very quick. We change the size to standard, and also the character color to a flashing color like this. You can click on OK. So we would change this before we export our document, because this way we can check if those numbers here match the number of the headline.
Okay, I hope you find this video helpful. I made this one in response to a request from someone from Korea. And if you have any trouble with InDesign or Illustrator and any questions to one of my other tutorials, just feel free to add a comment or write me an email, and maybe you get your own little video that answers the question. So, until next time, bye bye!